friends, and welcome to my November wrap-up. If you've been watching my wrap-ups, you know that I just do what everyone does. I talk about the writing style, the world building, the characters, I give you my rating. I mean, it's okay, but it's not really that exciting. So I knew I wanted to do something different with these wrap-ups to make it more enjoyable for you to watch and for me to do. And I got inspired by one of my favorite booktubers called BooksNest. She is doing these super speedy wrap-ups. She is describing the books in 30 seconds and then she moves on to the next. It just looks really fun and I'm gonna give it a try. So I'll leave her YouTube link because she deserves all the credits in my description down below. And if you like these kind of videos, then don't forget to click that subscribe button and hit that bell so you never miss another video of me again. Let's get started. In the month of November, I read a total of 7 books, 4 physical books, 3 audiobooks, and 3 different genres. First up is Six of Crows by Leigh Bardugo. Okay, here we go. It's a duology and it takes place in the Grishaverse. If you have read the Shadow and Bone trilogy, you'll definitely know what I'm talking about and you'll definitely like this duology. It's a diverse world where Grisha, the magical elite, roam the lands and Grisha wield the elements. The story is about 6 outcasts, some Grisha, some not, and they have to work together to pull off this heist. They have to free a hostage, and this hostage has a very important knowledge that can alter the future of Grisha everywhere. The author describes the book as an Ocean 11 style heist in a fantasy world, and I think that's a good description. Even though the world building is good, the story mainly focuses on the characters, their relationship with each other, their background stories. I had a lot of fun reading about all of them. I felt connected to each and every one of them. It's fast-paced, it's action-packed. I really enjoyed it and I gave it 4 stars. I don't know how long that took me, but it might even be under 30 seconds. Next is an audiobook, Abothes, A Breath of Snow and Ashes by Deanna Gabaldon. If you haven't read the previous books, then there's no use reading this book because every book starts where the previous book ended. So you really do need to read all these books. Yeah, and there are a lot. And they have a lot of pages. Story takes place in 7073 up until 7076, and we are still in North Carolina, where the Frasers have settled and are living in a colony. There's political unrest between the British governments and the Indian tribes, and of course Jamie is asked to act as an Indian agent. This means Jamie will be gone for quite some time, and while he's gone, something terrible happens to Claire. The Fairy Cross, the 5th book, was a little bit slow paced. Well, I say a little bit, but a lot, because nothing happened up until chapter 52 or something. But this book makes up for it. This book, everything happens, from kidnapping to physical assault, sexual assault, murder, and even a throuple, which is, if you didn't know, a relationship between 3 people. I love Deanna Gabaldon's writing style. She describes everything in such detail. The world building is great. The characters are great. She lets you feel every emotion possible. It's just a wonderful experience. I love reading about Jamie and Claire, and I gave this one 5 stars. The Devil in the Dark Water by Stuart Turton. I did an in-depth review of this book, so in case you're interested, I will leave a video up in the info cards. It's 1634, and a ship from the Dutch East Indies sets out for a voyage from Batavia to Amsterdam, which is the Netherlands where I live. Aboard the ship is Samuel Pipps, who is the world's greatest detective, kind of like a Sherlock Holmes, but in this case he's also a prisoner awaiting his execution, and his loyal bodyguard and friend Erend Hayes, who is determined to prove his friend's innocence. You might think you know where this story is gonna go. Well, you don't, because as soon as they board the ship, there are strange symbols everywhere. There are whispers in the darkness, and the livestock that is on the ship is slaughtered. And then it's up to Samuel and Erend and this noblewoman called Sarah Wessel to solve the mystery. There isn't much world building because pretty much the entire story takes place on the ship, but the author does a great job of describing the ship called the Sardom. So you get the feeling like you're there, and you'll also learn a lot of stuff about life at sea. You get to know quite a lot of characters, but the emphasis is really on the 3 characters that I named at the beginning. And there's also a passenger list, so if you ever get lost with these characters, you can just check it. I would describe this book as a mystery thriller with historical elements, a focus on character dialogues, and a brilliant plot twist. Even if you are reading like a detective, you are definitely not going to expect this plot twist, so that saved it for me. It would have been more enjoyable if the plot came a little bit sooner, but I still really, really liked it, and I gave this book 4.5 stars. Blood and Honey by Shelby Mahurin. Another book that doesn't make sense if you haven't read the first one, so definitely go read Serpent and Dove before you read Blood and Honey. Lou and Reed are on the run after the events that took place at Chateau Le Blanc, together with their friends Coco, Angel, Beau, and Madame Laval. Their goal is to find a way to stop Morgaine, and they turn to the Dame Bruce, who used blood magic, the werewolves, and the king in order to form an unconventional alliance. And I say unconventional because these are people that normally don't work together. It all takes place in Volterra, which I describe as a foresty island with medieval elements and French words. The author constantly switches between two POVs, our main characters Lou and Reed. This is really fun, enjoyable, fast-paced. However, the two characters are not really that distinguishable, which is weird because they are totally different persons and have completely different personalities. Then again, I love the dialogues, I love the amount of banter. Some people might call it childish, but it made me laugh. I mean, I'm there for it. Big Titty Litty, all that stuff. I just really liked it. There are new characters, there are background stories, political motives. They are going on this quest, and there's this big plot twist at the end that made me really curious about the third book. The story definitely has its inconsistencies, but I just still think it's a good fantasy read. I love the world of Belterra, I love the characters and the amusing dialogues. I gave it 4 stars. Next is another audiobook, The Tales of Beetle the Bard by J.K. Rowling. This was just a very fun and quick read. I read this book or listened to this book in one day. It contains 5 magical fairy tales that all have their own message. Each story has additional notes penned by Albus Dumbledore, which was really fun because he gave you some extra information or just some facts about life at Hogwarts or how it's all linked together, and that just gave this book an extra dimension, and I really enjoyed it, and I gave it 4 stars. Next up is The Beekeeper of Aleppo by Christy Lefteri. Our main character is Nuri. He's a beekeeper and he lives with his wife Afra, who is an artist, in the beautiful Syrian city of Aleppo. And then the unthinkable happens and the city is destroyed by war. So obviously this is based on a true event because Aleppo was destroyed by war and a lot of innocent people died. They go through an unspeakable loss and they see horrible things. They are forced to escape and their journey takes them through Turkey and Greece, and they try to end up in England. This is really a moving, emotional, and powerful story. The author based this on other people's stories because he worked as a volunteer with refugees from Aleppo, and she talked to these people and then merged their stories together and wrote this book. And you can really feel that. You can feel the raw emotion. It's really sad. It made me cry. I felt really invested in Nuri. I really got to know him and I felt his loss. And even talking about the book now gives me goosebumps, so I'm definitely gonna give this book 5 stars. The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue by V.E. Swap. Somehow I feel like everyone read this book in November because this book was all over Bookstagram and BookTube. The story starts in France, 1714, where we follow Addie LaRue, and in a moment of desperation, she calls to one of the gods, who is kind of a devil. She makes a deal with him, and in exchange for that, she gets to live forever, but she is remembered by none. So she can basically do anything she wants, and she kind of does, but it's really hard because you can imagine if you go to a place and you are talking to someone and then that person says, oh wait, I have a call, I'll be right back. And then when the person gets back, he's forgotten all about you. But everything changes because 300 years later, she meets a young man called Henry, who all of a sudden remembers her. What's fun about this book is that it is a very huge time span. So 300 years, you go to a lot of places, a lot of beautiful cities, she meets a lot of interesting people. So it kind of feels like time traveling. And then there's of course the romance aspect of it. It just all feels really whimsical. I would definitely describe it as a fantasy book, but not in a fantasy realm because it all feels really realistic. I've written down a quote that I think represents the book really well. Stories are a way to preserve oneself, to be remembered, and to forget. It's a unique journey with beautiful characters. It's kind of slow-paced, but still enjoyable. I gave it 4.5 stars. Those are all the books that I read in November. Let me know in the comments down below how many books did you read in November, and do you have any book recommendations for me, because I can always use those. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, then please give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and let's stay in touch.